Hey folks, welcome to the Wolf Den one more time. I'm having me a PBR and I'm working on a little project here. Y'all may be able to help me out. I don't know, but we'll see. Alright, well, let's start with a little history. You know, since I got my new Buck 110, I've been feeling a little nostalgic, I guess you could say. When I was a kid, I don't know how old I was. I don't really know, and I wish I did. I wish there was some kind of age group I could put with this. But this was my hunting knife. And you're going to say to yourself, geez, Dave, looks like a Buck 110. Well, unfortunately, there was a million knives back then that looked like a Buck 110. The Buck 110 came out in, what, 1964? And I'll say, let's see, I was born in 63. So I'd say this knife was probably early 70s, right around the early 70s or so is when I got this. It says on it, and I know you're not going to be able to see it because I can barely see it. It says Precision. I guess maybe that was the name of the company or the brand. And it says Deer Slayer. And the reason it was a Precision Deer Slayer, and the reason I never chose a Buck 110. I probably looked at them and just didn't even have any idea of what I was looking at when you're, 11 years old or whatever. But the reason I chose this one, because this was like a Christmas present to me from my parents, is because I thought, and I even faintly remember looking at this and saying, oh, well, this is the one you gotta have. This is the one you gotta have. Because if you're going to be, slaying all those deer, if you're gonna be slaying all them deer, which I didn't. I had the worst luck as a deer hunter. I don't even want to get into the stories, and I can tell you, between, let's see, rifle season, shotgun season, archery season, how I only shot one deer, and I didn't even down, I slowed him down, and some other dude hit him in the head with a 30-06 or something from across the field, and it was a big 7-point buck, and when I ran over there, I said, that's mine. I slowed him down. And he looks and I hit him right in the flank. So it was basically a gut shot. When he was with a Marlin 30-30 up in a tree. While it was running, because it got scared from a girlfriend of mine who was in a house screaming, Dave, there it is, there it is. Because it jumped out of her property, ran across the field, and I'll never forget, she was standing on the back porch of her house, and what I always used to refer to as her little Red Riding Hood nightgown or robe. It looked like a little Red Riding Hood. It was this big zip-up, bright red robe with a hood, and she's standing there. I can see her right across the field. She's standing there, jumping up and down. There's one! There's one! And that thing took off and was running across the field. And I had that 30-30 in a crotch of a dang tree branch. And I was trying to follow it like a duck. I was doing all I could to try to lead it. And I went, boom! And I hit him right in the flank. And he ran through a tree line. And I heard, and I looked and I scrambled down the tree, and this other guy downed him. So he said, it's my deer. Well, how old was I? I was in about the fight with this guy about it. And then he even said, you're not supposed to be hunting over here anyhow. You're supposed to be over there. I'm allowed to be over here. You know how they get. So, but back to the knife. The reason I thought that this is the one to have, because it's got a bone saw. It's got a bone saw. And I said, well, geez, if you're cleaning deer. I mean, it's so funny. If you're cleaning deer, you're definitely going to be whacking through some bones, ain't you? So I thought you have to have the bone saw. And I mean, if you take a look at it, I mean, I don't think I ever used it for bone. As a matter of fact, if I look in this, in the teeth of this saw, I think I still see wood in there. I did more cutting branches and twigs and stuff as a kid with this, but I carried this knife through thick and thin, through the woods. I lived out in the middle of no man's land back then, and I was just, you know, the great white hunter, explorer, you know, I was in the woods constantly, you know, with my trusty dog that was my hunting pal. Yeah, a German Shepherd. A German Shepherd that just went around scaring everything. So this really takes me back, and I've had it all this time. Just like, you know, people who do get their first Buck 110 or whatever, it's so nostalgic and everything. Now, if I do believe, this says something Japan. Okay. This is way before, you know, everything was made in China. Back then, if you wanted something less expensive and you didn't even know it, I mean, you know, I didn't know, I didn't pick this. I picked it because it had a bone saw. But it says something, I can't see it, I gotta get my glasses or something. All right, I went and got my glasses. Alright, let's see here. It says, patent pending, Japan. PAT.P, Japan. And of course, right here, back then, man, I thought I was the hot dog. You know, I had to. I just had to do this. I got an engraver off of somebody. And I, you know, those old style engravers, you know, that you, it was like a big Dremel looking thing and it had a little tiny carbide little point on it. You went in there and went, it went like crazy. And you had to practice a few times, you know, before you could ever do it. But I put my name right there at the base of the tang. So let's take another look at this thing while we're doing a flashback in time here. It doesn't say anything on the wood saw. And yeah, man, I'm telling you, there's still wood in the blades here. Or in the wood saw. Now, this thing has been beat to a pulp. I mean, back then, I didn't think nothing of chopping, and I could actually even see how right in here, between the wood and this bronze or brass space or liner in here, that it's actually kind of separating a little bit on this side. But see, there's no lock for this side. And I noticed it's got a nail nick. It's a little floppy. Now what I did, and this is where I might need your help, I don't know. It could be just because it's so beat. But I used a little of this. I used the brake parts cleaner. It comes out here, you know, non-chlorinated, you know, under some pressure here. I use this on reels that are really super gummed up to clean all the little parts. And what I did is I got in here in every single little space, right here at the thumb bar or the back lock. I shot it in there. I shot it all in here, because I mean, this thing was nasty. Super, super nasty. So, but see, it doesn't want to snap closed. And I don't know why. Something could be out of alignment here. Spacers or something, I don't know. This is where I was going to ask anybody. I don't know why, but I mean, it's still, it's a little, got some play, but I'll show you. Of course, here's my newest acquisition with the thumb stud that I put on here. And I mean, the dimensions of what they did to try to copy, you know, a buck. Everybody copied a buck, right? But this is a real buck, and this is a super modern buck with the S30V blade, made in the United States, polished nickel bolsters, G10 handle, and then again I went and put a black thumb stud on it. Now I can't say that this one's running exactly. This one's running not exactly super centered either. And I mean, it's brand new. So, I was wondering, I guess I got to get in here. I mean, I blew it out. And I guess I'll clean it up and just oil it and see. And I was going to sharpen it. I mean, it's sharp now. Let's see how sharp it is. Paper here. There's some Louisiana Sportsman magazine. Yeah, it's pretty sharp. You could use a... You could use a fine tuning, that's for sure. So, man, I'm watching all these videos on bucks. Really got my eyes peeled. Got my eyes peeled for basically this exact same knife that comes with an aluminum. It's all aluminum frame. And they're sold out. And they sell out fast. This one's extremely stiff until it reaches that. And see, that's what I was hoping I could get this one to do. But something's wrong with it. Right there's the detent. It's probably because this thing has been used to... See, there's no spring left. I don't know. I'll try oiling it and see what happens. I mean, it really doesn't matter. I mean, it really doesn't matter. I mean, it works. You know? But when you go to close it, you just better make sure you push it. See, when I push it all the way down, you can watch this back lock. The back lock moves. Right here, it'll move when I push. It goes in. So, I don't know what's wrong with this. Oh man, that's really messed up. Maybe I ought to retire it. It has a case. There's the case. Says Japan on the back. Had a cougar. Even though it's a deer slayer, it's not a cougar slayer. And all, I mean, look. look. I mean, I look at this and I instantly start going back to when I was a kid. I immediately look at this and that's where I go. And that's what's so great about keeping stuff like this. Because I remember when somehow this stitching got all frayed. And I think I asked my dad, how the hell can I fix this? And I don't know if I came up with it on my own, but I used rivets. I put a rivet there, a rivet there, and a rivet there. And it's been holding it ever since. Japanese, but I mean, look at the wear on there. So, I guess I won't be pressing this in the service because it just doesn't want to kind of be there. And I never liked this. Here's one thing I didn't like. I don't like this kind of belt loop. You know, I always wished it had like the buck comes with a separate loop on the back. So, all right, well, you know, maybe you could tell me if you've got something like this that takes you straight back. And I mean, I don't even know what age I was, but oh my God, this thing has some unbelievable miles on it. It probably did squirrels, and I mean, I did rabbits, and it did doves, and it did other bird, pheasants or something, you know. It did it all. So it didn't have to be a buck 110, but I might get in here and see if I can clean literally the wood. See, when I move that saw, this is moving somehow. See, it just pops up. I really wish I knew what was wrong with this. I mean, it's just out of whack so terribly. But, you see, the wood saw doesn't want to close. I'm not going to polish it. I mean, look at the patina on it. So, I just thought I'd share this. I'm pulling it out. I got this one on my mind, right? This brand new one here. I don't know if that thumb stud is. Well, there you go. I guess it's in the right position. Yeah. Maybe that's why the blades get pushed a little to the side, because you naturally, on a thumb stud, are kind of pushing to one side. So, but I just want to thank my parents for getting me this. I remember distinctly looking at these in a showcase at a big sporting goods store. The same place I got my first, you know, shotgun. And I said, that's the one. It's got a bone saw. And I never used it for bone. So thanks for watching. I mean, everybody and their brother does these type of videos. Except they're pointing down at their hands. You know, the knife guys that irritate the living hell out of me. You never see them. All you see is the camera hanging over their hands. And some of them got those damn lily white hands that I think they're accountants or something. So, thanks for watching. This is just another one to add to where I came from. Sitting around the house, got nothing to do.